stable. He never left her side. Though the boy was not his baby, she was still his bride. Proving himself worthy, like true love always does. The night God put his son and his trust in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. When that boy became a young man, he picked up his father's trade, working right beside him and learning more each day about the miracle that happens inside the workshop walls when you put the timber hammer and the saw in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. Weathered and worn, calloused and sore, but oh, the power that they give when you put a piece of wood and nails in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. He left the family business at 30 years of age, and quickly gained the reputation of a righteous renegade. The religious called him sinner, and the sinner called him friend, and the blind man found his sight again. In the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. Weathered and worn, calloused and sore, but all the healing that they when the very touch of God was felt in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. With a crossbeam on his shoulders and the thorns deep in his brow, they led him to a hillside out on the edge of town. But he only had forgiveness, not one ounce of spite, when the ones he came to save drove the spikes in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. Bloodied and bruised, broken right in two, but oh, the grace and mercy that they had. With splintered wood and rusty nails, in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter. Salvation flowed and love prevailed. The day the fate of this whole world fell, in the hands of a carpenter, in the hands of a carpenter.